Good morning, class 7. I am Praveen Tripathi, once again welcoming you in the session of computer. We are in our chapter 5, which is about more about HTML. And in the previous recorded session, I have told you about how you can insert an image to your HTML document that means to your web page. Now, the next topic is that how you can create hyperlinks. First, you need to understand what are the hyperlinks. I hope that you are accessing the Google Drive links which you are getting from your groups. So you have seen that blue colored underlined line. Whenever you have clicked that link, you will click on that line. So you will be redirected to the folders. You will be redirected to some other kind of locations. So these are known as the hyperlinks. Hyperlinks means it will redirect you to the new document, to the new file, to the new location, to the new folder. Okay. These known as the hyperlinks. Whenever we are considering the World Wide Web concepts, that means the web programming, so we have to create a hyperlink. So it will let us to jump from one document to another document. So creating hyperlink means creating a link, creating a path to the new document. So let's start the topic. As you know that www, that means World Wide Web, is a collection of billions of web pages connected with each other through links available in the form of images, buttons, text, and etc. You might have seen some kind of images. When you will click on that image, it will redirect you to the new document. So you can create hyperlink to the text also, to the buttons, or to the images also. By clicking on these links, you can move from one page to another page. So these links are called hyperlinks. You can create links between the web pages using a tag. A tag means anchor tag. Okay. Tag are defined in the angular bracket, and a tag means anchor tag. And its attribute is href, that means the hyperlink reference. You have to mention the hyperlink reference. What do you mean by reference? Reference means the address, the link of your web document from where you want to jump, from where you want to complete the path. Okay. So if someone will ask you what is anchor tag, so anchor tag is a container tag. Why we are saying that it is a container tag? Because it contains some file. Okay, so it is a container tag which encloses the object to be used as link on the page. So as you understand or you read the format, the syntax of the letters and application in your English subject, as similar to the English, as similar to the other type of format, we also follow the syntax of a language. Okay, so this is the syntax of anchor tag. First, you need to start your angular bracket. Then you have to write A, followed by href, attribute. Students will ask me that what is the tag and what is attribute. Tag is the main thing of the HTML document, and href or the any kind of attribute is the helping method of that tag. Okay. If you will talk about the image tag, image is a tag, and src, that means source, is its attribute. As similar to the image and src, A is a tag and href is an attribute in which you will enclose your path in the double quotes. Okay, path of HTML document. And if you want to write something to the text, so you will also include the text, and then it will be closed. How you close the tag? By the slash sign. So this is the format. The link text appears in a different color. When you bring the mouse pointer on the hyperlink, it turns to a hand cursor, and clicking the left mouse button once opens the linked document in the browser window. So when you will create a hyperlink, and when you will run it successfully, and when you will hover the mouse to it, the mouse pointer will turns into the hand cursor, okay, as shown in the screen also. So this is the code which we have given. We have to create HTML head followed by the title, and then we just close the head. Whatever the coding we do is, we do in the body tag. So in body tag, we have written the A, href, link, and then .html. Okay. This is the text which will appear on the screen. Click here to view information about Virat Kohli. Okay. And when you will click on this text, you will see the output as the Virat Kohli's image and the details about that player. So this is how you can create the hyperlinks. I will tell you the practical implementation also in the upcoming session, but first we will discuss the theoretical aspect of this chapter. You can also use the ATAG to create links with other websites or web pages on the internet by specifying their URL as the href service. So supposedly if you want to insert some website's address, supposedly you want to give the LPS Bikaner's school's website address to your website, so you have to just mention the URL of website. What do you mean by the URL? URL means the address of your website, that means the uniform resource locator, that kind of address, www.lpsbikaner.com. Okay, so you have to just mention that URL of website and you will find that your LPS Bikaner's website will be added to your web page. This is the code snippet we have been given, a href and http gramsbook.com and grambooks, and then followed by the closing tag of the A. So this is how you can create the hyperlink. Now if you want to use image as hyperlink, so what you need to do is you have to just recall that image tag. What is image tag? Once I have already told you the practical implementation of the image tag also. Start img followed by the src, and then you have to paste the path of your image. So first you need to write a href, path of your HTML document, and then image source, and then you will just close it. So this is how you can create or you can use image as the hyperlink. Now we will discuss the list. Very interesting topic in the HTML. I hope that you know the listing method. Everyone is using the list method. If you are using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 kind of serial number, then it will be referred as ordered list. If you are using ABCD, then it will also referred as the ordered list. If you are using Roman numbers 1, 2, 3, then it will also referred as the ordered list. Now we will discuss the example of unordered list. Unordered list means if you are using the bulleted points, if you are using arrows, if you are using hash sign to the listing items, so it will be referred as the unordered list. But before discussing the unordered list, I will tell you about the ordered list. Ordered list, as the name suggests, it will work on the ordering list. Okay, and its name is OL. You can simply identify OL means ordered list. The OL tag is used to define a sequentially arranged, mark my point, sequentially arranged number. Okay. So it is a container tag also because it will list down some items, and the li tag is a parent tag of the OL. So before going to use OL tag, you have to call the li tag, that means list tag. Li tag is used to represent individual list item within the OL tag, and OL stands for ordered list and li stands for list item. List item is an empty tag that does not require a closing. That means you do not need to close the li tag. Okay, so this is the format. First, you need to write the OL, and supposingly you are listing your name, let's say very basic example, Ram and Sham, and let's say Virat. So if you want to add this list item, so you will write OL, li Ram, li Sham, and then li Virat, and then you will just close this OL tag. So this is how you can list down your items in your web pages. Here the example being given: OL first item, second item, third, fourth, and fifth item, and then it will close. So this is how you can access the OL tag, that means the ordered list. And by default, ordered list items are marked with the numbers. So if you will not assign any kind of number, then it will start from the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. English, or you can say the English manner of counting digits. So it will start from that, 1, 2, 3. It will not define from A, B, C or Roman number. So if you want to create a list in which you want to just add the ABCD or the Roman number, so you have to use a type attribute. Mark my point, type attribute. Supposedly you want to create or display a list in which you are using A and then computer, B hardware, C software, and D process. So in this we are using ordered list, no doubt, but we are using ABCD instead of 1, 2, 3, 4. So for doing that, you need to mention the type or start attribute. So now we will discuss the type attribute. Here is the format of type attribute: ol followed by a type type equals to, and if you are combining a in the double quotes, then it will start the list from the a. And if you are using lowercase letters, then you have to write the small letter a. I for Roman numerals uppercase, small I for Roman numerals lowercase, and one for the Arabic numerals. So I hope that you are understanding my point, what I'm saying it. If you want to apply different type of type in your HTML list, then you need to mention the code also. Next thing, start attribute. This is a very interesting topic. Supposingly you want to create a list in which you want to display the list according to vowels. A for computer. Now instead of using B, I want to use E. E for hardware, I for software, O for processing. So mark up students, I am not using the correct format or the correct order of the alphabets, but I am using the ordered list A, E, I, O, U. So I am skipping the alphabets. So for skipping the alphabets, you have to use the start attribute. Okay. Start attribute of ol tag is used to select the starting number of the list so as to start the list from a number other than 1 or letter other than A. Supposingly you don't want to start your list from 1, don't want to start your list from A only, you want to start your list from F. So you can use the start attribute as the name is suggesting. So if you want to start your attribute from the A, so you just write the ol type, and if you want to start your tag from the F, so you need to write the start is equals to F. So this is how we have discussed the ordered list today, and for the remaining part of chapter we will discuss in the upcoming sessions. Okay, so take care, bye bye.